Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let's look at three very useful keyboard shortcuts that are actually turned off on your Mac by default. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 700 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So have you ever wanted to turn on Do Not Disturb, bring up the Notification Center, or launch Launchpad using a keyboard shortcut? Well, it's tricky to do those things because they really don't have specific menu items where you can set a keyboard shortcut for that. But there are actually reserved slots for keyboard shortcuts for those three things already set up in System Preferences. They're just turned off by default. So let's go to System Preferences, and then Keyboard, and then Shortcuts. And let's look at the very first one, Launchpad and Dock. And right here we'll find our first shortcut, Show Launchpad. It sure would be nice to bring this up with a keyboard shortcut, especially since you can launch an app with the keyboard in Launchpad. So if I click on Launchpad down here and I just type a few characters like that and hit return, it'll launch the app. The only problem is that I can't bring up Launchpad with the keyboard. I have to use the mouse and go over to it and click on it. But here I can simply enable the keyboard shortcut by checking the box here, then set up a shortcut for it. So since this launches apps, let's use Control Command A to bring this up. Now that that's set, Control Command A brings up Launchpad, and now I can just type some letters, use the arrow keys if I want, hit return, and launch an app just using the keyboard. And in a minute I'll show you some other shortcuts that you can use to launch Launchpad as well. Now let's look under Mission Control, and here are the other two I want to tell you about. First, there's Show Notification Center. So let's turn that on and let's set that to Control Command N for notifications. Now when I use that, you can see it brings up Notification Center on the right. Another one will dismiss it. And now let's turn on the Do Not Disturb on off switch here, and let's set this to Control Command D. Now if you look at the upper right hand corner, you'll see the notifications, those three lines there. If I use the shortcut, you can see it turns on Do Not Disturb, and that dims it. Another one will just reset it to normal, and you can see the three lines there are no longer dimmed. Now there are also trackpad gestures you can use to access two of these. So for instance, here under More Gestures, we have one for Launchpad. Pinch with thumb and three fingers. If you have that turned on, that's another way to use Launchpad. You have to use your trackpad for that, not the keyboard. Notification Center also has one. If you turn that one on, if you swipe left from the right edge of the trackpad, not the screen, with two fingers, it'll bring that up. And if you swipe right all the way to the right side of your trackpad, you can dismiss it. Now for turning on Do Not Disturb, you can always just click here, drag down, and then you can turn it on. But a shortcut for that is to just Option click here to turn it on or off. The keyboard shortcuts for all of these, I think, are a lot easier. Unfortunately, if you don't have a trackpad but instead are using an Apple mouse, there's no gesture for these. But there is something else you can do. You can use Hot Corners. If you go to Mission Control and then click on Hot Corners, you can set one of the four hot corners to do either Show Notification Center or Launch Launchpad. So you can replace those two gestures with one of these. A good tip is to not use just the hot corner by itself. Let's say we want to move to the upper right hand corner to launch Launchpad. But instead of just moving there, we can also say, let's do that but with Control and Command held down. Just hold those keys down on your keyboard and you'll see these menu items change. Then select. And now Launchpad will only come up when we move the cursor there, but also hold down the Control and Command keys at the same time. There are also some other kind of hidden commands you can look at on your Mac. If you go to Keyboard and then Shortcuts, and you go down to Services, you're going to see a list of all sorts of different services and keyboard shortcuts you can set to them. Now it's going to depend on which apps you have and also if you've created any services of your own, say using Automator or Script Editor. But some of them will be built into every Mac by default. For instance, here's one to launch Terminal and go directly to the current folder. And here's another one for looking up the current selection in the dictionary. So look through here and see what other keyboard shortcuts that you already have ready to go. You just need to enable them with the checkbox and add a shortcut for it. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.